It is news in recent months that Bausch&Lomb's acquisition of the IC8 cataract intraocular lenses, which had in the past few months had FDA approval, so it is a lens that had CE mark but was not saleable in the United States, had FDA approval, and now it has been acquired by Bausch&Lomb. This was a great move by the company because this lens is the only lens in the world that exists today for the correction of vision defects related to corneal changes. Let us consider the eye as a camera. This camera is basically composed of two lenses. The first lens is the cornea, the most powerful lens of the eye. The second lens of the eye is the lens. Let's pretend that the first lens, the more powerful lens, has a problem and has an alteration. So this alteration does not allow the patient to see in a definite way. There are many possible alterations of the cornea, but in particular we focus on corneal alterations resulting from surgery such as radial keratotomy, such as excimer lasers performed then in the early 1990s. With perhaps a very good outcome for the first few times, but with problems over the medium to long distance, and especially with qualitatively poorer visual performance with little light. Even patients with diseases such as keratoconus, corneal transplants, keratitis, trauma, are patients who have alterations in this important lens of the eye that is the cornea. How can we remedy this problem? It would be said by transplanting the cornea. Corneal transplantation is a procedure that is done very well, but it has the shortcoming of not allowing visual performance to be good, especially in the beginning, because of the irregularities that are formed in the sutures. Therefore, here, the smartest solution is to remove the lens, which is the second lens of the eye and is a lens that has a power that is about half that of the cornea, and therefore a tissue in quotes stupid, because the lens is a trivial lens that sits inside the eye and can be replaced with a plastic lens. This plastic lens is a high performance lens, and especially one with pinhole technology such as IC8 that allows aberrations to be eliminated. So here is the trick adopted by ophthalmologists, which is to remove the lens, especially if it is cataractous or even transparent in selected cases, to obviate corneal aberrations. So in case of corneal disease, in case of alterations not of transparency but of light transmission in the cornea, irreversible and stable over time, the solution is to remove the lens, have cataract surgery then, and insert in its place an artificial lens with pinhole technology, which is the IC8 lens.